Hello, my name is Alan Timara. I'm a PhD student at PUC-Rio. This is the research that I developed during my master's degree at LMMP on injectivity and stability of oil in our emulsions with lipophilic natural surfactants. Professor Marcio Carvalho is my advisor, and Ariana Pontes is my co-advisor. The main focus of this work is to explore experimentally the benefits of emulsion injection as an enhanced oil recovery method. In a brief review, the secondary methods consist of the water or gas injection into the reservoir to displace the oil. They had low sweep efficiency due to the high mobility ratio between fluids that leads to viscous fingers formation and the oil water breakthrough. So oil ganglia are trapped by capillary forces and a large amount of oil remains in the reservoir. In this way, UR methods are applied in the reservoir to increase the oil recovery, and emulsion injection consists of a chemical UR method. As the emulsion drops flow through the porous media, they act as a mobility control agent, blocking pore passages already swept by the water. So it diverts the water to unswept paths, reducing viscous fingers and the residual oil saturation. And also, a pressure gradient is created around the oil ganglia, displacing them. Consequently, oil production is maximized. As a motivation, a field test in California reported by McAuliffe in 1973. Oil production was in decline, represented by the continuous line in this graph, and the produced water was increasing, according to the triangles. Then this water with oil droplets as an emulsion bank was injected into the reservoir, and as a result, additional oil was recovered, and the produced water decreased, indicating positive responses to emulsion flooding and better sweep efficiency. Thus, the produced water can be injected into the reservoir as a new method, and to exploit its benefits, this emulsion needs to be stable. Clode oil is a complex mixture of hydrocarbons, and many of its components, such as asphaltenes, resins, and naphthenic acids, can stabilize in the face by chemical interactions, acting as a natural surfactant. They form a film around the oil and water interface, providing a barrier against coalescence. In this context, the goals were to study the formation and stability of emulsions stabilized by fatty acids, similar to naphthenic acid. It was done by intentionally choosing the oil and water phase to study ideal emulsion systems stabilized by one of the molecules found in the oil production process. Evaluate the effects of several parameters such as salinity, pH variation, fluid composition, and temperature. And also study the flow behavior of stable emulsions through sandstone injectivity tests. Emulsion stability was studied by monitoring the formation of the oil film over time using burrow tests and analyzing the evolution of the drop size distribution. Using the Mastersizer, which provides statistical T-values parameters, the 0.5 and 0.9, that represent the diameters of which 50% and 90% of the drop population has a diameter smaller than this value, respectively. Inertial properties were studied using a Teclis tensiometer and a Platen ring tensiometer. Several model systems were evaluated bearing the composition of water and oil, surfactant concentration, temperature, speeding, and mixing time. And I'm going to introduce one of them that was applied in the injectivity tests. Stearic acid was chosen as a natural surfactant due to its simple molecular structure. Its carboxyl is preferable to water, and its carbon chain is preferable to oil, so it can absorb it at oil and water interface. A mixture of hexadecane and toluene was considered as the oil phase. The aqueous phase was composed by a buffer to maintain a basic pH of the solution. It was prepared with tris and hydrochloric acid. It's a weak base, and in the presence of the acid, it reacts like this, with a buffer capacity between 79 pH at 25 degrees Celsius. The emulsions were prepared with 95% aqueous phase and 5% oil phase, topped with different concentrations of stearic acid, homogenized by a NutraTour. And studies were carried out at ambient conditions. In the oscillating test, the drop detached from the needle almost immediately after contact with the buff solution, as can be seen in this video, indicates low interfacial tension. Furthermore, due to the presence of the buffer, the solubility of stearic acid in aqueous phase may be increasing, causing the destabilization of the film. Then the interfacial tension was measured for different concentration in a plate and ring tensiometer. And analyzed the graph, stearic acid can promote interfacial tension reduction with 0.3% of the minimal interfacial tension. Stable motions were formed, and a model system protocol for formulating them was selected to recreate these emotions and using them in the injectivity tests. The first injected emotion, EM10, was prepared with these characteristics here, with the 0.5 and 0.9, about 4 and 10 micrometers, respectively. This figure showed the microscopy analysis. It was stable for 15 days without oil film formation by model tests. The second emulsion, EM13, was prepared with the same composition, however, with longer mixing time and speed. So it was more dispersed, as can be seen in the drop size distribution and the microscopy analysis. And also it had smaller droplets than EM10, about 2 and 4 micrometers of the 0.5 and the 0.9 respectively. It was stable for 96 days without oil film formation by model tests. The injectivity tests were performed in a cold flooring system and consisted of injecting the emulsion continuous phase, the buffer, followed by the emulsion at the selected flow rate with 2 power volume per flow rate. Permeability loss due to the emulsion blockage was evaluated by rejection of the buffer after emulsion injection, and the pressure behavior during the injections was analyzed. And also, emulsion and effluence was evaluated to check the drop, breakup, retention, and percolation in the porous medium. The cores used in the core flooring tests were Benheim sandstones, composed predominantly of quartz with approximately 2,500 millidarcy of permeability. This is a simplified scheme of the experimental setup used, which consisted of an oven with a core holder where the sample is confined, and 3,600 psi was applied as an overbound pressure at room temperature. Pumps and accumulators for work fluid and emulsion injection, transducers to measure pressure, and also fracture collector for effluent analysis. In the first injectivity test, EM10 emulsion with greater drop size distribution was injected. And this graph here compares the differential pressure response of buffer and emulsion injection. The pressure during emulsion injection did not stabilize for low flow rates and was higher compared to continuous phase injection that may evidence drop filtration during emulsion injection and clogging of the porous medium. The drop size distribution of the effluent was compared to the original one for its flow rate. I show here, all distribution curves are shifted to the right and show the multimodal distribution over time, evidencing a coalescence process. Here, the pressure behavior during the buffer injection before and after emulsion injection was compared, showing permeability reduction more than 90%, resulting in a severe rock damage. These results may indicate that the drops in a facial film would not have sufficient elasticity to deform and cross the porous throat, nor withstand the injection pressure. In the second injectivity test, EM13, the emulsion with smaller drop diameter was injected. Comparing the pressure behavior between the buffer and emulsion injection, as expected, the emulsion pressure response was higher than that for the buffer injection. However, for low flow rates in this region, there were higher pressure fluctuation. This may indicate that when the drop meets the porous throat, the pressure behind the drop needs to overcome the capillary pressure to percolate, and when that happens, the pressure drops. Therefore, the large pressure oscillation shows that the droplets block the pores and deform until they can proceed. This graph here is the result of the work made by Gillen et al., in which a mobility reduction factor F was proposed to describe the behavior of the emulsion injection, calculated as the ratio of the average pressure measured during continuous phase flow to that of the emulsion. F was plotted in relation to the capillary number. For low capillary numbers, F is much less than 1, and the block is relevant. And for high capillary numbers, F is approximately 1, and the block is away. In this way, as capillary number decreases, capillary force predominates, and the droplets that formerly percolate the porous medium remain rapid. This graph here shows the mobility reduction factor calculated with the results of the second injectivity test, which has similar behavior compared to the given results. And a critical capillary number equivalent to 10 feet per day was defined. The drop size distribution of the effluent did not show significant variation, indicating that the droplets were able to form when passing to the porous medium. And finally, this graph shows that the damage caused by the emulsion was only 16%, very low compared to the previous test. The emulsions with smaller droplets caused the blockage expected by the emulsion jet as mobility control agents. So, as final remarks, the presence of the stearic acid in the oil phase promoted interfacial tension reduction. If that's important interfacial activity, evaluate our flow rate, emulsion size, and emulsion stability is fundamental during emulsion injection to avoid injectivity loss. Water mobility control was observed during emulsion injection to reduce permeability reduction as a strong function of emulsion drop size distribution and capillary number. This work corroborates the potential for using produced water. And for future works, it's important to analyze the role of other molecules such as naphthenic acids, resins, and azotins, and even form emulsions with crude oil. We form oil displacement cost learning tests under reservoir conditions as pressure and temperature. Thank you for your attention.